Welcome to Sunday Sermons. Today's sermon was given in Topeka, Kansas. So let's sit back and listen to the spoken word of the Lord.
Today is the 15th Sunday after Pentecost, and the epistles taken from St. Paul to the Galatians. If we live in the Spirit, let us also walk in the Spirit. Let us not be made desirous of vainglory, provoking one another, envying one another. Brethren, and if a man be overtaken in any fault, you who are spiritual, instruct such a one in the spirit of meekness, considering thyself, lest thou also be tempted. Bear ye one another's burdens, and so you shall fulfill the law of Christ. For if any man think himself to be something, whereas he is nothing, he deceiveth himself. But let every one prove his own work, and so he shall have glory in himself only, and not in another. For every one shall bear his own burden. Let him that is instructed in the word communicate to him that instructeth him in all good things. Be not deceived. God is not mocked. For what things a man shall sow, those also shall he reap. For he that soweth in his flesh of the flesh shall also reap corruption. But he that soweth in the Spirit of the Spirit shall reap life everlasting. And in doing good let us not fail. For in due time we shall reap, not failing. Therefore, whilst we have time, let us work good to all men, but especially to those who are of the household of the faith. If we live in the Spirit, let us also walk in the Spirit. What does it mean to walk and live in the Spirit? That is, with the Holy Ghost. John of St. Thomas says, "Moreover, anyone who turns freely to pleasantries and vanities, either to hear or speak them, is still imperfect in the Spirit." He further tells us that if we do not give up the comforts and delights of the world, but easily go back to them, we are not strongly inspired by the gifts of the Holy Ghost. To live in the Spirit, we must detach from the things of the flesh, that is, from worldly pleasures, in order to enjoy the spiritual pleasures that the Holy Ghost gives to those who truly live the life of the Spirit. Be not deceived. God is not mocked. We are not truly gods if we have not departed from the world and its false fleeting pleasures. We can call ourselves Christians and Catholics, but if we do not live by the maxims of the Gospels, but by the maxims of the world, then we are liars. And God will tell us so at the moment of our death, before reading the sentence we have earned of eternal condemnation. St. Alphonsus tells us, "The maxims of the world are, it is necessary to possess wealth and property, to seek the esteem of others, to indulge every amusement within our reach." And St. Paul also tells us, "Be not conformed to the world, but be renewed in the newness of your mind." Let us depart, therefore, from worldliness and live a life with the Spirit. Please stand for the Gospel. In the Gospels taken from St. Luke, "And it came to pass afterwards that he went into a city that is called Nain, and there went with him his disciples and a great multitude. And when he came nigh to the gate of the city, behold, a dead man was carried out, the only son of his mother, and she was a widow. And a great multitude of the city was with her, whom when the Lord had seen, being moved with mercy towards her, said to her, 'Weep not.' And he came near and touched the bier, and they that carried it stood still, and he said, 'Young man, I say to thee, arise.' And he that was dead sat up and began to speak, and he gave him to his mother. And there came a fear upon them all, and they glorified God, saying, 'A great prophet is risen up among us, and God hath visited his people.'" Please be seated. Jesus had compassion on this mother, whose son had just died, and restored him to her. Let us consider that the worst death is the death of the soul, which comes through sin. Let us ask Jesus to restore us to life and health of soul. And we should take another lesson from today's Gospel. No man knows the day nor the hour when the world will end in regard to him. Death can come us at any time of life. It could come this very day. we are not promised to see the sunset. Let us consider a story. Let us consider that we are all in a prison where several hundred prisoners are locked up under the sentence of death. However, none of us have been told the date of our execution. On occasion, the guards come to call out the name of a person to take that person off to their execution. And often it is the person who is least expecting to be called. Wouldn't your heart tremble every time you heard the key turn in the lock to open the door to summon another to execution? My friends, we are all under the sentence of death. So why do we live as if we shall remain in this world forever? While we're amassing worldly goods and spending our time in worldly pursuits, we forget that we cannot take any of this with us. What foolishness! How does any of this prepare me for my home in eternity? At the moment of death, this world will cease in regard to you, and you will have to make that awful accounting of how you spent every moment of your time and every penny of your wealth. Have you laid up treasures in heaven, or have you squandered the talents God has given you for the salvation of souls, both your own and those around you? In the Rosary, in the joyful mysteries, we pray for detachment from earthly things. So let us detach ourselves from earthly things so that we can attach ourselves to God. Earthly things will only drag us to eternal misery in hell. God, on the other hand, will sanctify us and prepare us for eternal happiness in heaven, if only we allow Him to take full control of our soul. It is time for us to remove all the ropes of worldliness that are holding us here and are waiting to drag us to eternal misery. Let us cast them off and throw them on the fire of divine love and inflame our souls with this holy love. In eternity, we'll be extremely happy that we detached from the world and mortified ourselves. It may cause some pain here, but even the worldly know that for success, no pain, no gain. We are seeking eternal success, which is eternal happiness in heaven. Let us live our lives as we truly believe this. It is not enough to say, "Lord, make me a saint." We must then learn what it means to be a saint and conform our lives to that holy ambition.
Hello, Vatican in Exile Catholic Radio is a 100% free internet radio station that depends on the gifts of its listeners. We don't offer gimmicks or gadgets or promises of wealth and health, just all Catholic-based radio all the time. It is through donations like yours that the VIE Catholic Radio Network can broadcast the Catholic faith to so many listeners around the world. You can make a special financial contribution to help us at VIE Catholic Radio right now online. Just go to the website viecatholicradio.com, and under the donation tab, you can make your online contribution, or you can send checks or money orders to the address also given in the VIE Catholic Radio donation tab. We want to say thank you ahead of time for what you are able to give. As Matthew chapter 10 verse 8 says, "Freely have you received, freely give." Vatican in Exile Radio, a Catholic voice, a city of refuge in a wilderness of confusion.